Hello friends, today we are going to start the daily current affairs through MCQs for February 11, 2020. And you are watching Civil's Tayari channel. If you like the video, please click the subscribe button. So let us begin the current affairs for today. Question number 1. With respect to national water policy, consider the following statements. Statement 1. It has been envisaged by Department of Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Rejuvenation, Ministry of Jal Shakti. Statement 2. The main objective of the policy is to take the cognizance of water sector. And you have to tell which of the above statements is or are correct. So yes, it will be under Ministry of Jal Shakti, and Ministry of Jal Shakti also includes Department of Water Resources as well as Ganga Rejuvenation. So statement 1 is correct. Statement 2. If it is water policy, so yes, it will take into cognizance the water sector. Everything about water sector. So both the statements are correct. So the answer will be both 1 and 2. So let us understand what this is all about. This is very important because any policy if government is making, more so you must have seen water stress has been a constant talk in many of my videos as well as many of the PIB. Most of the news which I am taking from PIB. So it is very, very important. This has been there in PIB as well, and that is why it becomes very important. Now let us understand. Now to understand the present water challenges in the water sector, there has been a revision of water policy has been envisaged by the Department of Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Rejuvenation. Now this drafting committee for new policy, there is already a water policy. The government is trying to reformulate this policy, and for this they have set up a drafting committee which was set up on 5th November 2019. Now the main objective of this policy will be to take the cognizance of the existing situation in water sector. That means they want to see if there is water stress, or what is the level of water stress, how many districts are having that, what is the level of groundwater resources and so on. And then they want to propose a framework of for creation of laws and institutions as well as a plan of action with unified national perspective in planning, management and use of water resource. So we do not have a comprehensive policy that talks about a unified national perspective in planning, management and use of water resource. So for this policy has been envisaged. Now Department of Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Rejuvenation, Ministry of Jal Shakti has prepared a draft memorandum. So why was this in news? Because a draft memorandum has been prepared, and the structure and activities has already been prepared by this committee. Now let us see question number 2. With reference to the 13th Conference of Parties on Convention of Migratory Species, consider the following statements. Statement 1. It is being hosted in Gandhinagar, Gujarat. This is correct. Statement number 2. The CMS logo is inspired by Kolam, a traditional dance form of Kerala. So now you must be knowing that traditional dance form of Kerala is not Kolam. So statement 2 becomes wrong. Right? So the answer is A1 only. Now let us see what is the explanation. So the 13th Conference of Parties of the Convention of Migratory Species or CMS is going to be hosted in India at Gandhinagar in Gujarat. So the theme is the theme of CMS 30 COP 13 is Conference of Party 13 is Kolam art form and not dance form, art form, right? And it is used to depict the key migratory species, like in India has Amur falcon, humpback whale and marine turtles. The mascot is Gibi or the Great Indian Bustard. It is a critically endangered species and it has been accorded the highest protection status under the Wildlife Protection Act of 1972. Now let us understand something about the Convention on Migratory Species. Very important. Now Convention on Migratory Species is an international treaty which was concluded under United Nations Environment Programme. And it is concerned with conservation of wildlife and habitats on a global scale. CMS convention is also known as Bonn Convention because its headquarters is at Bonn in Germany. Now, CMS is the only global and UN-based intergovernmental organization that is exclusively established for the conservation and management of terrestrial, aquatic, and aviation migratory species. See, migratory species means any species which moves from one place to another. See, species do not see the boundaries or borders. For them, borders do not matter. So these species keep on migrating from one place to another when they do not find the suitable life conditions. Now, this species, CMS or the Bonn Convention, what it does is, it helps in intergovernmental coordination for the conservation of those species which move from one place to another place, right? So it is the only UN-based convention that is exclusively dealing with conservation of these migratory species. Now what happens is, because migratory species have a habitat in two or three different nations, that is why their conservation requires an intergovernmental effort. Secondly, it is a very difficult to conserve such species, and many of them are endangered as well. So it is important to have a intergovernmental convention. Now India is host, right? Because it will be hosted in COP will be hosted in Gandhinagar. So India is a host. Now every host country is designated as a president. So India will be a president, and it will be president for next 3 years. Now India is a signatory of Convention on Migratory Species since 1983. So you need to know since when India is a signatory. Now India is also taking necessary actions to protect and conserve marine species, migratory marine species. Now, seven species, marine species include dugong, right? Then whale shark, marine turtle, two species of marine turtle. So, 2+1, 3+1, 4. And they have been identified as a preparation of conservation and recovery action plan. Now, India is home to many migratory species of wildlife, like you have snow leopard, Amur falcons, bar-headed geese. This is very, very important. Please learn this as it is. Any of these can be asked. So India is a home to various migratory species, and which includes snow leopard, Amur falcon, bar-headed geese, black-necked cranes, marine turtles, dugongs, and humpbacked whales. Now this India has signed a non-legally binding memorandum of understanding with Convention on Migratory Species on the conservation of, see, for four species India has signed a memorandum of understanding, and it is non-legally binding. First is Siberian crane, second is marine turtle, third is dugong, and fourth is raptor. So you need to learn this data, very important. There are four species on which India has signed a MOU. Siberian crane in 1998, marine turtle in 2007, dugong in 2008, and raptors in 2016. This is the theme and logo. So the logo is this. It shows the Kolam art form, and the you can see these species which are given here. This is turtle, then you have whale, humpbacked whale. So all they have been represented in the Kolam art form, and this is the mascot. This is what Gibby or Great Indian Bustard. Now consider the following statements about the National List of Intangible Cultural Heritage. Statement 1, this list is being compiled by Ministry of Culture in collaboration with UNESCO. Statement 2, Sangeet Natak Academy is the nodal agency for scheme. So you have to tell which of the above statement is correct. Statement 1 only, 2 only, both 1 and 2, neither 1 nor 2. Now you see national list is being prepared. So if national list is being prepared, UNESCO should not play a part. So if you put that logic, statement 1 becomes wrong. And Sangeet Natak Academy is really a nodal agency. So statement 2 is correct. So the answer is 2 only. Now let us understand, as per the information which was given today in Parliament, so as per the information provided by the Minister of Culture in the Parliament today, Sangeet Natak Academy, an autonomous organization under the Ministry of Culture, is the nodal academy for scheme called Safeguarding the Intangible Cultural Heritage and Diverse Cultural Traditions in India. Now Sangeet Natak Academy is collaborating with Zonal Cultural Centers of Culture Ministry to prepare a list of intangible cultural heritage elements for the National List of Intangible Cultural Heritage. So what a Ministry of Culture is doing, it is preparing a list. Now this list will contain all the elements that are included in India's intangible cultural heritage. Okay, and for this, who is collecting the data? Sangeet Natak Academy is collecting the data by collaborating with zonal cultural centers. Now the list is being compiled by and it will have at least 100 elements. So list is being compiled and it will have at least 100 elements that will be considered as in India's intangible cultural heritage. And every year 20 new elements will be added through to this list. Now UNESCO has not collaborated because this is totally a project of Ministry of Culture. So statement 2 is wrong. Now see question number 5. Consider the following statements about Genome India project. Statement 1. The project ultimately aims to build a grid of Indian reference genome. Statement 2. Ministry of Health has initiated the project. Now you have to tell which of the above statement is or are incorrect. Now if you know that it is a genome project and genome comes under biotech. So if this is a project of biotechnology, Department of Biotechnology does not come under Ministry of Health. It comes under Ministry of Science and Technology. So statement 1, 2 becomes wrong. Now similarly, it is not ultimately aiming to build just a grid of reference. Sorry, you have to tell which of the following statement is or are incorrect. Okay, so it is not building a grid of Indian reference genome. It is actually mapping entire Indian genome. So both 1 and 2 are wrong. So the answer is C, both 1 and 2 are incorrect. Now see what Genome India project is aiming. It is aiming to build a grid of, ultimately build a grid of India reference genome. Second, it wants to understand fully the type and nature of common diseases. Third, it understands to understand the trait that comprise the diverse Indian population. Sorry, statement 1 is correct. Statement 2 is wrong. So the answer will be B only. Please correct it here. This will be B only. Only 2 is incorrect, right? Because the Genome India project is aiming to build a grid of India reference genome. Then it will try to understand the type and nature of common diseases. And it will understand the traits. Traits means all those characteristics that comprise the diverse Indian population. So this project is being spearheaded by Center for Brain Research at Bangalore based Indian Institute of Science, which is the nodal point for about 20 institutions. Project is initiated by Department of Biotech under Ministry of Science and Technology. So since Ministry of, what is given here? Ministry of Health is given here. So that is why the statement 2 is wrong. Statement 1 is correct. Answer should be only 2 is wrong. 2 only is the answer. Now see question number 6. With reference to Solar Orbiter Probe, SOLO, consider the which was launched recently. Please consider the following statement. It is a flagship venture of NASA and JAXA. Statement 2. Mission is intended to perform detailed measurements of inner heliosphere and nascent solar wind. So statement 1 is wrong because it is between NASA and ESA, European Space Organization, and not JAXA. So statement 1 is wrong. Statement 2 is correct. It is going to study the inner heliosphere. So the answer is, which of the statement is correct? So the answer is 2 only is correct. Now see the mission. Mission is a flagship venture between European Space Agency or ESA in collaboration with NASA. Now mission is planned to last 7 years. So it will be studying the heliosphere for 7 years. It will perform the detailed measurement of inner heliosphere and nascent solar wind. It will be put within 42 million square kilometers. Sometimes this data can be asked. So it will be put within 42 million kilometers of the sun's surface to perform close observation of the polar region of sun, which is difficult to do from earth. So you know the polar region, this region of sun. So it will be in the inner heliosphere, very close, 42 million kilometers from the sun, and it will try to understand the study. It will try to understand the polar regions, or it will observe the polar region of Sun. Now the spacecraft will make a close approach at Sun every 6 months. It will come very close to Sun every 6 months. And it is designed to carry a large payload of scientific instruments to the region close to the Sun. So the goal is to study Sun and the magnetic activity in heliosphere. Now we will understand what is heliosphere. See, heliosphere is a vast bubble-like region of a space which surrounds and is created by Sun. So a region of a space which is surrounding Sun. So this is Sun, right? This is Sun. Now the space, the region that is surrounding Sun, that will be called heliosphere. Now this space is created by Sun and it surrounds Sun. It defines the boundary of the solar system. It is basically the area under the Sun's influence. Now what Sun does, Sun keeps on sending constant flow of charged particles called solar wind. So you know about solar wind. Sun keeps on sending the solar wind to the outside. So in heliosphere, the solar wind will be maximum. And this the solar wind forms a giant bubble around the Sun, and this is known as heliosphere. Now the need for mission. The Sun will occasionally eject billions of tons of matter and entangled magnetic fields that can disrupt activity of the Earth. That has happened in the past. Sun keeps on sending lot of energy, billions of tons of energy, which affects the cycles at Earth. Now the worst of these storms, what they will do? They will trip the electronics on satellites, they will interfere with radio communication, and they will shut down the power grids. So researchers from this solar probe, they will want to improve the models of forecast of the worst outburst. So they want to understand. They want to understand when the Sun is going to do this, and how can we overcome this difficulty, which can cause lot of massive damage on the Earth, because you know satellite are electronic radio communication, everything in a set will be shut down. Now as we are depending more and more on the electronic item, it becomes a very big threat on the Earth, right? So this is all in news today. You can see the diagram also here. See, flipping of magnetic field happens every 11 years. And the biggest solar storm was recorded in 1859. So now we want to understand how this storm will come again, and what will be the how we can protect ourselves against this storm through this solo mission. So that is all in news today. Thank you so much. If you like the video, please click the subscribe button and please press the notification bell. Please share the video and please spread the word. You can find the PDF at the Telegram channel. The link will be provided in the description box. Thanks a lot.